Is it safe? In your kitchen, you encounter millions of microorganisms each day. Like their name suggests, microorganisms are too small for you to see unless you have a microscope. While some of these microbes are helpful and necessary, others can make us sick, like E. coli and Salmonella. These are called pathogens, and they cause foodborne illness. The first line of defense against these pathogens in your kitchen is cleaning. The simple act of washing can help you stay safe in the kitchen. So where do we start? We all know to wash our hands to keep from getting sick, from things like flu or colds. But it's actually really important to prevent foodborne illness as well. In fact, most food-related illnesses from restaurants are traced back to a lack of proper hand washing. Scientists have actually studied people washing their hands to figure out the most effective method of pathogen removal. Here's what they found. Start by rinsing your hands to get off the top layer of dirt and grime. Add soap and scrub your palms, backs of hands, in between fingers, and nails to get any stubborn microbes off. Ever heard of the 20-second rule? It's actually based on scientific data. Studies have shown that it takes a full 20 seconds to get maximum microbe removal when washing your hands. When you've done your 20 seconds, rinse your hands thoroughly and dry them on a paper towel. Using a cloth towel can recontaminate the hands you just worked so hard to clean. The next line of defense is washing surfaces and utensils after each use. Cutting boards, dishes, utensils, and countertops can be contaminated after cooking or food prep. So it's important to wash and clean them after each use. If you have a sink, you can do a two-step method where you wash first and then sanitize with a solution like bleach. If you didn't want to have to use bleach, you can use hot water too, but you have to get it really hot, almost boiling. Have a dishwasher? If you load items up in a dishwasher, it actually cleans and sanitizes them in one step. Just remember, whether you hand wash or use a dishwasher, always let things air dry. Just like with your hands, you don't want to recontaminate the dishes that you just cleaned with the cloth towel. Your kitchen is spotless, so can you still get sick from foodborne illness? You actually can. Pathogens can be directly on your food, which is why it's important to take action before you eat. All produce, unless it says pre-washed, needs to be washed before eating. Rinsing under running water will do the trick. You don't need any special produce washes. For firm fruits, like cantaloupes, use a produce brush to scrub the outside. So why wash if we plan to cut or peel? Anything on the surface of this cantaloupe will be transferred inside when you cut into it. So if there are pathogens here, they could go to the fruit you're about to eat. So what about other foods, like eggs and meat? It might sound odd, but washing these foods can actually increase your chance of getting sick, because it spreads pathogens around your kitchen. Take this raw chicken, for example. There's so many pathogens on the surface of this meat, it'd be impossible for you to wash it all off, and you can't get your water hot enough to kill it. This is actually why we cook chicken to 165 degrees Fahrenheit. But we'll talk about cooking another day. If you have questions related to food safety, you can contact me here at Alamance County Cooperative Extension, or you can go online to foodsafety.gov. We'll see you next time on Horrors of the Kitchen.